बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। अस्सलाम वालेकुम माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज योर साइंस टीचर मिसेस मदीहा अशरफ। वेलकम टू ऑल ऑफ यू इन जनरल साइंस क्लास। स्टूडेंट्स, इन आवर टुडेज क्लास वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द मेजरिंग ऑफ वोल्टेज। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल रिकैप आवर प्रीवियस लेक्चर। इन आवर प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस्ड द ट्रांसफर ऑफ एनर्जी like in an electric bulb. The energy conversion take place is electrical energy converts into light energy and heat. So any electrical equipment or appliances is there, it converts electrical energy, that is the input energy, into some output. What is the source of this electrical energy? Or the power, that is the power supplied by using of cell, batteries or generators. Like if you notice what is written on these are V, 1.5 V, 3 V, 9 V and many more. What this V is, this is the voltage. So recall, what is voltage? Voltage is the pressure or it is the force from an electric circuit's power source. Like what is the power source here? This is a cell which is shown as positive end and the negative end. This power source push the electrons or the charges inside this circuit. In other words, that is named as current. The flow of charges is named as current. So this power source push or force the charge to flow. Then there is a electrical appliance like lamp is there. So this electrical energy inside the lamp or bulb convert into light and heat. So what makes the flow of charges or flow of current? This work is done by the power source, and that energy is named as, or that force is named as, voltage. So how we can define voltage? Voltage is the pressure or energy from an electric circuit power source that push the charges or electrons to pass through the conducting loops. These are the wires, these are conducting loops, or enabling them to do work such as illuminating a light. We will see in detail what is the flow of electric charge, what we call it. See this electric circuit. What are the components of this electric circuit? There is a power source or a cell. These are the electrons or charges which are passing or completing the pathway. What the force is which is responsible for these flowing electrons, that push is named as voltage. There is an other component that is named as resistor. As the name shows, resistor, there is something in the circuit which try to stop the, or which try to slow down the flow of these charges. That is named as resistor. So what is the flow of electric charges? Electric charges flowing in an circuit is named as electric current. So what is electric current? Electric current is the flow of electric charges through a material. The charges must flow continuously or without stopping. So the rate of electric current through a wire is how much charges passes a place in a certain amount of time. Rate, how much charges passing in a time t, is named as electric current, and it is measured in a unit that is named as coulomb per second, or in simple unit is a 1 ampere. What is the unit of electric current? The unit used for rate of electric current is ampere. And how it is written? It is written as A or AMP. In shorthand, we can write AMP or A along with the quantity, like 1 ampere current, 2 ampere current. So we can write AMP or simple capital letter A is used. How the electric current in a circuit can be measured with the help of an instrument? That instrument is named as ammeter. What the name? Ammeter. It is used to measure the current. We will define electric circuit. You should know how we can define the electric circuit. Electric circuit is a pathway. A current needs a path to follow. An electric circuit is an unbroken path, or it is a complete path through which electrons are flowing. So this complete path that is followed by the electric charge is named as electric circuit. Electric circuit, if it is complete or unbroken, then current will pass. If it is incomplete or broken, then charges will stop and no current will flow. What is the voltage? Charges need energy to flow. The energy that makes the charges flow is named as electric potential energy. For example, battery. We have seen in previous example, battery or a cell is used that supplies the electric potential energy in an electric circuit. So what is voltage? Voltage is the difference in electric potential energy between the two places or between the two points in a circuit. There is the potential electric potential energy difference. That electric potential energy difference is named as voltage. And other name of voltage is also used, that is named as potential difference. What is the unit of voltage? Voltage is represented in volts, V-O-L-T, volt, and it is abbreviated as V. What are the sources of voltage? Recall, sources of voltage are battery, cell, or electric generators. Why it is needed? Because charges need energy to flow through a conducting wire, and this energy is provided by a power supply, and this power supply is the battery or electrical generator, battery or cells. Now we have the two circuit diagrams in front of us. Can you tell in which one there is voltage and there is current, and which diagram there is both voltage and current? See the first diagram. Can you identify the components? What these components are? These are, first one is the switch, and this is not closed, this is open. This sample is used for a cell or battery, and there is a device connected in this circuit. Is this the complete circuit? Yes or no? This is not a complete circuit. So what is the voltage or current in this case? Is there any voltage? Yes, there is voltage in this circuit. See, voltage but no current. Why there is no current? Because the switch is open, so circuit is broken. Power supply is there, voltage is there, but no current is flowing because the controlling switch or the pathway is incomplete. So that's why current cannot be passed through it, and there is no current in this circuit. And what about this circuit? In this circuit, you can see the power supply, cell is there, battery is there, yes, the voltage is there, yes. Circuit is complete, yes, circuit is complete. So there will be any current or not? Yes, both voltage and current in this circuit. The switch is closed, making a complete circuit, so current can flow. Let's see another case. What happened in this case? There is no voltage and no current. Can you guess why? Because there is no source of voltage. There is no source of voltage. No cell or battery is connected. So that's why if there is no voltage, no current. Now, can you make the difference between current and voltage? What is current? Can you define? Current is the flow of electric charges. And what is the voltage? Voltage is the push, or it is the energy that is forcing the current to pass in a circuit. In this illustration, you can see voltage is pushing the current to pass, or it is forcing the current to pass through a circuit, while there is another factor that is named as resistance. What is the role of resistance? Resistance just try to provide the hindrance or resist or trying to stop the flow of current. To overcome the resistance, there is a need of energy. That energy is provided by the voltage. voltage is directly proportional to the current. If there is high voltage, high current will pass. If there is low voltage, low current will pass. And what will be the relation with the resistance? If there is more resistance, can current pass easily? No. If there is low resistance, current will flow easily. So it means current and resistance both have indirect or opposite relation with one another. While V and I, V for voltage and I for current, both has the direct relation with one another. In both these circuit diagram, what is shown? Voltage or potential difference that is shown by positive and negative end. This small line is for negative end and the capital line is for the positive end. So electrons are flowing from negative end towards the positive end inside this circuit. There is a conductor. Now you can find out the voltage across any two points by help of an instrument. Similarly, in this diagram, the voltage source is there and current are passing or electrons are flowing from negative end towards the positive end. And inside the circuit, there is a component that is named as resistance. What this resistance is? Resistance is the opposition, or you can say it is the hindrance that try to stop or that try to slow down the flow of charges. To overcome this, we need a voltage source. How we can measure the voltage? Voltage inside a circuit can be measured with the help of a voltmeter. What is a voltmeter? Voltmeter, it is an instrument that measures the voltage or potential difference in volts, is known as the voltmeter. Two types are shown here. Voltmeter, which we use in our labs, V is written over there, which means it measures in V. And this is the pointer which moves and find it out that how much voltage inside the circuit is there. In representation or in circuit diagram, how we represent the voltmeter? By using the circle and alphabet V is written inside. That show the voltmeter. How to use the voltmeter inside an electric circuit? Voltmeter is always connected in a parallel. You already know or familiar with the series and the parallel circuit. Series circuit are those in which all the components are connected one after another in a single straight line, you can say. While parallel circuit, in which all the components are not connected in a straight line, but it one or other components are outside the circuit. Like in this diagram, voltmeter is parallel to this circuit. While battery, resistance and the load written, these are in series, only the voltmeter is connected in parallel. Why this voltmeter is necessary to connect in a parallel? Because inside a voltmeter, there is the high resistance. We have to measure the voltage or potential difference inside a circuit across any two points. Then we connect the voltmeter in parallel. If we connect the voltmeter in parallel, the amount of current passing through the voltmeter is very less. Why it is very less? Because inside the voltmeter, there is a high resistance. So the current through the circuit is unaltered, or it is do not change. While if we connect it in series, like we connect this voltmeter here, what will happen? It will not measure the current accurately. Because of the high resistance, it will minimize the current that is flowing inside the circuit. So amount of the current do not remain same. So that's why voltmeter should be connected in parallel whenever we have to find out, like we have want to find out how much voltage across this point and this point, means to say across this resistance how much voltage or how much potential difference is there. Then we can find it out by connecting a voltmeter in parallel to this resistance. Similarly, we want to find out the voltage across the load or lamp or any other component, then we have to connect the voltmeter in parallel, not in series. How we can do this? suppose a circuit diagram is there. When the voltage is supplied, electrons start moving from one end to the other end. The direction of electron flowing is shown by this arrow, which is moving down. Now it reaches to this point where the bulb or the lamp is placed. What the energy changes take place, this electrical energy will convert it into light and heat at this point. So it means the energy is lost here, and then at this point it will be changed. So the potential difference will change because it is used by the bulb now. We want to find out the potential difference across this point. So where we will connect the voltmeter? We will connect the voltmeter across these two points here. See how? In this way. Where we have connected? We have connected the voltmeter across these two points. Because the potential difference we have to find out between these two points. It will connect the voltmeter in this, then it will not identify the accurate value because it is having the high resistance. High resistance inside the voltage means it will not allow the current to pass, or it minimum amount of the current will pass through it. So amount of current will not remain same, and this will not give you the accurate value. While A is written here, it means ammeter, that is used to measure current. It is used inside the circuit in series. Voltmeter is connected in parallel, while ammeter is used in series. Let's see what is wrong in these two diagrams. Ammeter is connected in parallel and voltmeter is connected in series. So both are incorrect version. Why? Because voltmeter is connected in parallel, while ammeter should be in series. To find out the accurate, voltmeter measures the voltage while ammeter measures the current. Voltmeter has high resistance and ammeter has less resistance. Both opposite, or you can say, just because of the amount of resistance used. Did you know the cells? If we connect one or more cells, then it makes a battery connected in series. Like this is a cell which is providing 9 volt. What is it? This is a multimeter that is measuring the voltage. This battery is giving the 9 volts. If 9 volts cells are connected with one another, 3 cells are connected with one another, how much voltage of this battery will be? That will be 9 multiply 3, because 3 cells are there. So 9 multiply 3, that will give you the 27 volts. And this is measured with the help of a voltmeter. And what is the relation with voltage with current? High voltage, high resistance. High voltage and high current. Think of voltage just like a pressure in a water pipe. More voltage means more pressure. More pressure means more water. So more voltage means more electrons flow, or more current will pass through the circuit. This is the end of our today's lesson. Now come to the test yourself. First question is, what is voltage? What is voltage? You have to define voltage along with its unit. Second part is about what is the unit of voltage. What is the unit of voltage? You have to identify. Voltage is measured in volts and represented by V sign. Question number three is, what is the voltage of a battery that is made up of 3 1.5 volt cells? We are using 1.5 volt cells. 3 cells are connecting with one another. Then battery is formed. What will be the voltage of this battery? This is similar to the we have done did you know diagram. So what will be your answer? Cells are joined to make battery. If 3 cells having 1.5 voltage are joined, it will produce 4.5 volts battery. How? You can add or multiply 1.5 plus 1.5, then come out what will be your result. That will be 4.5 volt battery. So what is the key point here, or the point to be noted, is cells make a battery. Number of cells grouped together to make a battery. Question number 4, from the lecture, what instrument is used to measure voltage? Can you name that instrument? Yes, that instrument is what? That instrument is voltmeter, that is used in parallel to the circuit to measure the voltage. Question number 5. Question number 5, a student connects 3 1.5 volts batteries in series. She measures the total voltage with voltmeter, expecting was 4.5, but original that comes out only 1.5. So you have to find out the reason behind what is wrong, or which connection is not connected properly. What do you think? Why the expected and the real answer both are different? This is just because voltmeter is not connected proper, is not connected properly. Voltmeter must be connected in parallel to measure accurate voltage, but the student has connected it in series. That's why our answer is not appropriate or accurate. Student, this is all about our today's lesson. Practice it well. See you in the next class. Allah Hafiz.